Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering channel. And as you know that we are following the heat transfer operations module these days, and in this regard we are bringing the lecture which is focused on LMTD, log mean temperature difference. If you remember our previous lecture, which was lecture number 9, we had discussed that for the analysis of heat exchanger, two type of methods are used. Number one is LMTD and number two is effectiveness NTU. Effectiveness NTU will be covered in the upcoming lectures, and today our focus will be on the LMTD, log mean temperature difference. Now the temperature difference between the hot and cold fluids varies along the length of the heat exchanger. Obviously, once we talk about the hot stream is flowing here, the hot stream is coming out, the cold stream is going in, and the cold stream is coming out. So at a certain point, or if we divide the whole heat exchanger length into several points, then at each point there is a difference in delta T, which is between hot stream and cold stream. So accordingly, we have to take a mean temperature difference, and the correlation becomes Q is equal to UAS, total surface area or heat transfer area, delta T M. And there are various correlations of LMTD for co-current parallel flow heat exchangers, counter-current heat exchangers, cross flow, and multi-pass heat exchangers. So we will discuss all these correlations one by one. Number one is parallel flow heat exchanger, and we have discussed as well previously that the hot fluid and the cold fluid enter from the same side and they leave from the same side. Delta T1, which is this one, represents the difference between the TH in and TC in. Delta T1 is equal to TH in. The H represents hot streams, C represents cold stream. Delta T2 represents TH out minus TC out. So accordingly, from this correlation we can see, or we can say easily, that the TC out can never be greater than TH out. And accordingly, the correlation for the log mean temperature difference is that delta T1 minus delta T2 over natural log of delta T1 over delta T2. There are a lot of nomenclature available or literature available that how to derive that equation. You can use it, or if you want me to explain, I can explain it in the upcoming videos. The temperature difference between the two fluids decreases from delta T1 to delta T2. Obviously, if you remember our graph or the chart for temperature profile, that the delta T1 is higher and exponentially it decreases to delta T2. So accordingly, there is a thought to take arithmetic temperature mean difference, which is delta TAM, and that is calculated as delta T1 plus delta T2 multiplied by 1 by 2 or half of the sum. However, the logarithmic mean temperature, it gives the clear picture of the temperature profile by tracing the actual temperature profile of the fluids along the length of the exchanger, and is an exact representation of average temperature difference between hot and cold fluids. So accordingly, this is a drawback with the average temperature or the arithmetic temperature, that it gives information or takes into account delta T1, which is at one end, and delta T2, which is at the second end. However, the LMTD, it gives point-to-point information and accordingly the exponential decay of the local temperature difference. Delta TLM, which is log mean temperature difference, will always be less than delta TAM, which is arithmetic mean difference. It means that if we assume delta TAM, we are overestimating the rate of heat transfer in an exchanger. When delta T1 differs from delta T2 by no more than 40%, that the value of delta T1, for example, is 10, and the delta T2 value is in the range of less than 40% difference, then there is a margin or there is an error of 1% in the calculations. But once their difference increases, this percentage error increases. So it is better to use LMTD in the calculations while calculating or computing the rate of heat transfer in a heat exchanger. So this is the overall representation of parallel flow heat exchanger, and we have seen that why we need to use LMTD, because it covers the whole heat exchanger. Number two, it gives the exact information about the temperature profile, and accordingly, it does not overestimate like that of the arithmetic mean temperature difference. Now, if you talk about the countercurrent heat exchanger, the geometry is a bit different because this is the hot fluid inlet. However, right now, this one previously was the cold fluid inlet, while here it is cold fluid outlet. This one is cold fluid inlet, this one is cold fluid outlet. The hot fluid inlet remains the same. So accordingly, delta T1 correlation is modified as TH in minus TC out, where H represents the hot stream, C represents the cold stream. And here delta T2 is equal to TH out minus TC in. It means that the hot outlet could not be more than the cold inlet. Similarly, the cold outlet could not be more than the hot inlet. However, if you remember previously where we have said that the hot out should always be greater than cold out in case of parallel flow heat exchangers. Here, this rule is not existent because if you look at this, this has no relation with the hot out. So cold out can be as high and can be even greater than the hot out, but it cannot be greater than the hot in because otherwise that value will become negative. And the correlation for the delta T logMIN temperature difference is same as that of the counterflow, which was developed for the parallel flow as well. Note that the hot and cold fluids enter the heat exchanger from opposite ends, and the outlet temperature of the cold fluid in this case may exceed the outlet temperature of the hot fluid. In the limiting case, in the excessive case, the cold fluid will be heated to the inlet temperature of the fluid. However, the outlet temperature of the cold fluid can never exceed the inlet temperature of the hot fluid, since this will be a violation of second law of thermodynamics. So we have seen this point. Now, if we compare counter versus cold flow, in the counter flow system, the value of LMTD is higher than that of the cold flow or parallel flow system. So accordingly, if we look at the relation, which is Q is equal to UA delta TM, and if we want to compute A, then A is inversely proportional to the delta TM. It means higher the logMIN temperature difference, smaller will be the area, and vice versa. So accordingly, since the value of LMTD for the counter current system is higher, accordingly the low value of heat exchanger area or the smaller value of heat exchanger area will be required, while opposite in case of co-current. So therefore, it is a common practice to use counterflow arrangements in heat exchangers. Next, we move to the multi-pass cross-flow heat exchangers. Currently, the correlation, which is LMTD, which we have developed for parallel flow and counterflow, delta T1 minus delta T2 over natural log of delta T1 over delta T2, was only for the counterflow or parallel flow system, while for cross-flow or multi-pass shell and tube heat exchangers, these cannot be accepted. However, the complex correlations are formed for that, and to simplify that correlation, it is convenient to use delta T logMIN temperature difference is equal to F, which is a correction factor multiplied by delta T logMIN temperature difference of cross flow or multipass systems. So an additional parameter is added for the cross flow or multipass system, which was not present in counterflow or parallel flow systems, where the F is the correction factor. And it depends on the geometry of the heat exchanger, the inlet and outlet temperatures of the hot and cold fluid streams. Now, if you look at this example, or this Q is equal to UA, previously it was simply delta LM. But now this F is multiplied, so it becomes Q is equal to UAF delta TLM. The delta TLM formula is same, but since it is multiplied by the F, that correction factor is an additional part in the cross flow heat exchanger. Obviously, complex equations could have been used, but to simplify the system, and to ease to use the process for the cross flow and multipass shell and tube heat exchangers, this equation has been developed. The correction factor for cross flow and for multipass shell and tube heat exchangers will always be less than 1. And for counter flow, it will always be 1. So we can simply say it is a measure of deviation of LMTD from the corresponding value for the counter flow case. So the correction factor is basically dependent on two parameters or two temperature ratios, P and R. And P is calculated as T2 minus T1 over T1 minus T1. This small t represents the tube side temperature, while the capital T represents the shell side temperature, no matter which type of fluid is there, either cold or hot. Two represents outlet, one represents inlet. Similarly, this R, it is equal to capital T1 minus capital T2, which is of shell side, divided by T2, small t2 minus small t1, which is of tube side. Two represents outlet, one represents inlet. And this is the correlation between P, R, and F. And as you can see, this x-axis represents the P value. For example, if its value is 0.6, and these are the curves or lines which represents the R value. So if 0.6 corresponding to this 0.8, then we get a value of F as 0.65. So accordingly, the correction factor is calculated for different values of R and P. And this graph is for one shell pass and 2, 4, 6, any number multiple of two tube passes. But accordingly, if it has more shell passes, then the graph will be a bit different. So you can find this graph in various literature books. So that's it from this lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Also, click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned.